ओके हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर एनटीए लेक्चर। सो इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव सॉल्व्ड द 3 to 4 एग्जांपल्स बेस्ड ऑन द सुपरपोजिशन थ्योरम ऑफ टाइप 1। ओके सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू टू सॉल्व द न्यूमेरिकल एग्जांपल्स, बस दोज एग्जांपल्स आर बेस्ड ऑन टाइप 2। सो in type 2 already we have defined what do mean by the type 2. So type 2 means at least one dependent source should be present along with independent sources. So condition of independent sources is fixed, that is minimum 2 independent sources should be present in the given network. Along with that, if any dependent source is present or number of dependent sources will be present, then that example we can consider under type 2. And there will be the some different technique to solve those type of problems. So I will take one of the example, and that example we can solve so that we can get idea how to solve the type 2 examples based on the superposition theorem. So I hope the screen is visible for everyone.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So type 2 problem I will take here. First of all, the question will be like this. Question number I will write here. So, type 2 numerical examples. Numerical examples on SPT, that is the superposition theorem. So here question I will write: determine current Ix in the circuit. Determine current Ix in the circuit using superposition theorem. Okay, so this will be the question here. Now the diagram will be like this. We don't know still whether it is type 1 or type 2. Based on the observation only, we can classify it. So this is 20 volt. This will be 5 ohm. This is 30 ampere, but direction of current is downward. Here it is 1 ohm. And here it is dependent source is present, and that dependent source is voltage source whose value depends on 4 into Ix. But question is, where is Ix? So Ix is given, which is flowing through this branch. So this current is Ix. So how to solve now this example? How to start this example? Anyone? Already we have solved type 1 examples. So first of all, what you have to do? You have to write the name of theorem which you are using to solve this example. Okay, so superposition theorem you are going to use. So for identification, you can write this is the type 2. Why it is type 2? Anyone can tell why it is type 2? Because here dependent source is present, but along with that independent sources you have to count whether minimum 2 are there or not. So here 20 volt voltage source is present. 30 ampere current source is present. So only two independent sources present, and along with that dependent source is present. Means if it is satisfying the condition, then we can easily apply the superposition theorem. Now, based on the observation of the circuit, we have identified that this problem we can solve by type 2 method, okay, or method 2. Now, in method 2, we are taking one independent source at a time, but we are not changing any dependent source. We are not replacing dependent source, okay? Value will change, but dependent source should be present as it is in the circuit. It remains as it is. Dependent source, you cannot make it open, you cannot make it short. You have to keep as it is, okay? Only one independent source you have to consider at a time, and you have to find out the value of Ix, okay? So first of all, I will take 20 volt as it is. Then you can find out response Ix1. After that, 30 ampere you can take as it is and find out Ix2. And finally, you can add Ix1 and Ix2. You can get the answer Ix. So this is the algorithm we can say to solve this type of example. So first I will take when only 20 volt voltage source, 20 volt voltage source is acting alone, and 20 volt voltage source is acting alone. So we have to draw the diagram by keeping 20 volt voltage source as it is and dependent source as it is. But what about current source? Anyone? Current source kya karaycha?
Open circuit.
Yes, so current source you have to make it open. So I will remove the current source by open. So this dependent source as it is, plus minus polarity as it is, this resistor value remains as it is, 5 ohm, this is 1 ohm, this is 20 volt as it is, and current source I have removed, that I have made open. Now tell me, what will be the value of current? What will be the new name of current? Anyone?
I1
kiwa Ix1 gya, karan Ix getle idu already given as Ix. So you can take as a Ix1. Am I correct? Barabar hai? Ix1. So if here Ix, then value of voltage source is 4 Ix. Barabar hai? Ha kutla type hai voltage source cha? This is the type of current dependent voltage source, CDVS. Current dependent, current, how voltage source hai, it's a value, current worthy depend hai, Ix. So Ix is current flowing through this branch. So that's why the name of this circuit will be, this source will be CDVS, that is current dependent voltage source. So if Ix is here, then value will be 4 Ix. If Ix1 is there, then what will be the value, new value here? 4 into Ix or Ix1?
Ix1.
Yes. So if here the value will change, the name will change, here also the name will change. So many students are making mistake here. They will change the name Ix1 here, but they cannot change the name here. They will keep Ix as it is. Due to that, what will happen? Two variables will be created. Actually, Ix variable by J, that is Ix1. So unnecessarily in the equation, two variables will come and they cannot solve that equation. But then the equation is solved. Okay. So this is the presence of mind. So the problem solve. So if it is Ix1 here, then the value of this voltage source also change. That will become 4 into Ix1. Now Ix1, how to find out this current now? By which method we can find out? Series circuit is there. In series circuit, which thing we can apply? Current division, voltage division, KVL, KCL.
KVL.
Yes, so KVL we can apply here. So KVL apply in a clockwise direction. You can apply the KVL here in clockwise direction. So according to the IX1 direction, direction of IX1 already it is shown. So here it is plus, here it is minus, here it is plus, here it is minus. This plus minus already given, this plus minus already given. So apply KVL in loop. Then I will apply here from this point. I will go in a clockwise direction. So minus to plus, that is the plus 20 here. You can write. Next, minus to plus 5 ohm across 5 ohm, minus to plus, sorry, plus to minus is there. That's what minus 5 into current IX1. Next, 1 ohm plus to minus is there. That's why 1 into IX1. Next, come to the voltage source. This is a dependent voltage source, but plus minus polarity is there. That's why minus will come here. But what is the value of that voltage source? So that voltage source the value kiti hai? That is 4 into IX1. The value of this voltage source is 4 into IX1. Okay, that I will write here. E is equal to what? E is equal to 0. So only one variable is there. That is IX1. One equation, one variable. You can directly get the answer here. जर तुम्ही इथं फक्त आय एक्स ठेवलं तर तुम्हाला आय एक्स वन बरोबर आय एक्स वन असेल देन यू देन इट इज डिफिकल्ट टू फाइंड आउट द आन्सर सो कॅल्क्युलेट आय एक्स वन फाईव्ह मायनस वन मायनस फोर टोटल हाउ मच इट इज मायनस टेन आय एक्स वन 20 गोज टू द राईट हँड साइड बिकम्स मायनस 20 मायनस मायनस विल कॅन्सल देन आय एक्स वन इज 20 डिवायडेड बाय 10 मीन्स 2 एम्पियर Okay, so you got IX1 as a 2 ampere. Now next, we have completed the half part. Second part is what? Second part. What we have to do now next? काय करायचं
कन्सिडरिंग ओनली 30 एम्पियर्स करंट सोर्स
ओके सो व्हेन ओनली 30 एम्पियर करंट सोर्स इज ऍक्टिंग अलोन इज ऍक्टिंग अलोन इन द सर्किट देन वी हॅव टू ड्रॉ द डायग्राम सो व्हॉट वी हॅव टू डू The 20 volt voltage source, short or open?
Short.
Yes. So 20 volt voltage source, we have to make it short. So current source direction. See the direction of current. Many students are making mistake here. They will take the upward, but in the exam, they example they have given downward. So take as it is 30 ampere. So this is 1 ohm. Now dependent source. You can keep as it is plus minus so this will be 4 I will write now what will be the value or name of new current now
IX2
yes so this current will be new name that is IX2 so if it is IX2 what will be the value of this voltage source
4
IX2
yes 4 into IX2. Hey, samjhayla pahije. Those who are understanding this one, they can easily solve such type of examples. So as soon as the name of IX will change, the value of dependent voltage source will also change. Okay. So now question is how to find out this IX, by which method we can solve this example. By which method we can solve this example? We cannot apply the current division because dependent source is there. So if you want to find out the IX current, then node voltage we have to find out. Node voltage divided by phi ke liye IX2 hai na. So node voltage, by which method we can find out? nodal?
Nodal analysis.
Yes, so node analysis we can use. Okay, so here the name I will take as a VX2 geto, because V1, V2, instead of that, if I am taking in synchronization, when yala synchronization karun jar ghetla, that will be easy. So IX2, VX2, like apan yamak vagere manto na, rhyming words like this, IX2, VX2. So VX2, I will take the name here. Okay. So IX2 ito value dilel nahi hai, but take as outgoing here. You can take outgoing. This is outgoing already 30 ampere. And this is also you can take as an outgoing. It is very incoming tomorrow, what does the sale? But value is not known. If value is known, then you can take as it is along with direction. But value is not known. So according to our original method, you can take outward. The value might sell the direction outward, guys. So these two currents are outgoing, you are marking, and this 30 ampere already given outgoing. So assumption, what will be the assumption here? VX2 is greater than zero. Okay. And VX2 is greater than 4IX2. The two assumptions you have to write. VX2 is greater than 0 volt and VX2 is greater than 4 into IX2. 4 into IX2 means how a voltage source is. Tejapeksha VX2 greater than asa tumhala assumption karav lagel. So all are the outgoing, all are the positive. VX2 minus 0 divided by 5 ohm. Next plus 30. Next plus VX2 minus 4IX2, because that is voltage, divided by 1 ohm is equal to what? 0. So if nothing is there, 1 is always there below the 30. So LCM is what? LCM is 5. So 5 here means 1. Here multiply 5. Here multiply 5. Okay, 1 into VX2 is VX2. Next, 30 into 5 means 150. Next, 5 into VX2. And 5 into minus 20, that is 5 into minus 4 means minus 20 into IX2. Is equal to 0. Okay, so VX2 total, it will give what? It will give 6 VX2. 6VX2 minus 20IX2. 150 goes to the right hand side, becomes minus 150. Okay. Now, this you can consider as a equation number 1. Now, how to replace this VX2? VX2 to me observe kara. VX2 is nothing but voltage across 5 ohm, but current is opposite. IX2 is flowing like this. So, VX2, if you are considering, then VX2 becomes negative. Let me dive to it. Okay, so I will show here how to find out VX2. Itparan konala ka adchane? Up to this step, anyone having queries?
No, sir.
IX1 already we got. Yes. Anyone having queries? Okay. So, okay. Now, I will consider this separate part. Okay, ita kaya nar baga, ita VX2 hai tumcha, and this is 5 ohm resistor. Okay, so current is flowing like this. So if VX2 is here, the meaning is that according to current, this is plus and this is minus. So VX2 value is nothing but minus this current. This current is IX2. Minus IX2. Into 5. So VX2 is nothing but minus 5 into IX2. So put in equation number 1. Put this in equation number 1. So I am talking about this branch only. okay, left hand side branch. So that I have taken separately here. So put this Vx2 is equal to minus pi Ix2 in the equation number one. So you can replace 6 into minus okay, so here you can put here 6 into minus 5 Ix2 minus 20 Ix2 as it is equal to minus 150. So minus 6 into minus 5 is minus 30. Minus 30 Ix2. Okay. So it will give minus 30 Ix2 minus 20 Ix2 is equal to minus 150. So total it will give minus 50 Ix2 is equal to kiti aate Ix2 cha value. So minus 50 Ix2 is equal to minus 150. How much the value of Ix2 we can get now?
3 ampere.
Yes. So we can get the value of Ix2 is equal to 3 ampere. So Ix1 is 2 ampere and Ix2 is 3 ampere. So finally, what we have to add? What we have to do now?
Ix1 plus Ix2.
Yes. So by superposition theorem, we have to add Ix1 and Ix2. Okay. So that will be the last step in this problem. So by SPT, the current Ix is equal to Ix1 plus Ix2 is equal to 2 ampere plus 3 ampere. That will give us Ix is equal to 5 ampere. Okay. So such type of example we have to solve.
तिला भाव ती एवढ्यात पप्पा एक सरीच खोद बघ.
एनीवन हॅविंग एनी क्वेरीज रिगार्डिंग दिस एक्झाम्पल? कोणाला काही क्वेरीज असतील तर विचारू शकता. So this will complete the superposition theorem and the example based on the superposition theorem. So number of examples are mentioned in the assignment. So at the end of this chapter, this unit, I will give the assignment. You can solve the number of examples which are present in the assignment booklet. Okay. So we can stop the superposition theorem and we can start the Thevenin's theorem. So once again, I will ask if anyone having any questions, you can ask. Otherwise, I will start the superposition theorem. Any kind of questions? Okay. The screen is visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we have completed the superposition theorem. Now we are moving towards the Thevenin's theorem. Next theorem. So Thevenin's theorem, we can understand by using these four pointers, four questions. So what is the Thevenin's theorem? How to apply the Thevenin's theorem? Procedure to apply the Thevenin's theorem based on the type of circuit, method one, method two, or type one, type two. And next, fourth one will be the applications of Thevenin's theorem. So by using these four pointers, we can discuss the Thevenin's theorem. And we are, you people, you can try to understand the Thevenin's theorem by using these four pointers. So quickly we can start the Thevenin's theorem. First of all, I will tell the Thevenin's theorem and then I will elaborate and explain the meaning of each and every line which are present in the Thevenin's theorem. So Thevenin's theorem states that any two-terminal linear network consisting of number of independent sources, number of dependent sources, and linear components, that is resistor, inductor, capacitor, etc., can be replaced by an equivalent circuit. Which consists of number of independent sources, dependent sources, resistor, it totally can be replaced by or converted into a single equivalent circuit. So that equivalent circuit consists of single voltage source VTH in series with resistor RTH. So that equivalent circuit is known as Thevenin's equivalent circuit. Okay, so graphically I will tell that how to do and what do we mean by the Thevenin's equivalent circuit. Now we can convert the any complicated circuit into Thevenin's equivalent circuit, which consisting of single voltage source in series with resistor between two terminals. But how to find out the value of voltage source and value of resistor, that is given in the second paragraph, where the value of voltage source is equal to, or we can find out the value of voltage source, that is by opening the two terminals, and we can find out the open circuit voltage across two terminals of the network. Between these two open terminals, you have to find out the voltage. That voltage is nothing but the value of voltage source VTH. Similarly, how to find out the value of resistance RTH? That is equal to an equivalent resistance measured between two terminals of the network. So already we have solved number of examples how to find out the equivalent resistance. In the prerequisite, we have covered it. So this is what the Thevenin's theorem. So how to remember the Thevenin's theorem? First of all, remember the condition where you can apply the Thevenin's theorem. Thevenin's theorem we can apply only in two-terminal linear network. Okay, it should be linear network and having two terminals. So which consisting of number of independent sources, at least one should be there. Number of independent sources, dependent sources, resistors, inductor, capacitor, that totally can be replaced by a single equivalent circuit whose name is Thevenin's equivalent circuit, but it consisting of a voltage source VTH in series with impedance. Actually, if all resistors are there, then we can tell it resistor. If inductor capacitor is there, then we can call it as impedance. Then how to find out the value of voltage source? That is, we can find out by open circuit voltage across two terminals of the network. And value of resistance we can find out by finding an equivalent resistance measured between two terminals of the given network. So that's why in the prerequisite only I told the equivalent resistance plays very, very important role in the unit number one, in the unit number three, in the unit number four, in the unit number five, six, everywhere. So everywhere we require current division and equivalent resistance. That do these two concepts we require a lot. Okay, so we can move towards the next point. Same theorem we can try to understand. This is what in the text form. Now same theorem we can understand by using graphical method or by using diagram. We can try to understand. So anyone having any questions related to Thevenin's theorem? So this is what graphical method, or by using a block diagram, we can say we can try to understand the Thevenin's theorem. So actually there will be two terminal linear circuit. So anyone can tell what it should consist? काय काय असणार आहे त्याच्यामध्ये, असू शकणार आहे टू टर्मिनल लिनियर नेटवर्क. टू टर्मिनल मीन्स द टर्मिनल्स आर शोन हियर. टर्मिनल्स आर शोन हियर, ए एंड बी. ए एंड बी आर द टर्मिनल्स, दॅट्स व्हाय इट इज कॉल्ड एज टू टर्मिनल लिनियर सर्किट. मीन्स व्हॉट? Linear circuit means what?
Inductor, capacitor, resistor.
Okay, so it should consisting of linear circuit elements, that is inductor, resistor, capacitor. Now next one, if two terminal linear circuit is there, which consisting of linear elements, number of independent sources, dependent sources, whatever it may be, but at least one independent source should be there. Ek tarah ek independent source asala paije. It may be type 1, it may be type 2. Mag tya don terminal cha across jar load resistor asel, if any load is connected, okay, so this will consider the entire given network. So it is complicated, so that can be replaced by a single equivalent circuit. पूर्ण नेटवर्कचं आपल्याला रूपांतर कन्वर्शन कशामध्ये करायचं? सिंपल इक्विवेलेंट सर्किट. त्याला नाव काय आहे? द नेम ऑफ दॅट सिंपल इक्विवेलेंट सर्किट इज थेव्हिनिन्स इक्विवेलेंट सर्किट. मग तो थेव्हिनिन्स इक्विवेलेंट सर्किट म्हणजे काय? द व्होल्टेज सोर्स व्ही टी एच कनेक्टेड इन सिरीज विथ रेजिस्टन्स आर टी एच बिटवीन टू टर्मिनल्स ऑफ द लिनियर नेटवर्क. सो दिस पार्ट इज कॉल्ड एज व्हॉट? थेव्हिनिन्स इक्विवेलेंट सर्किट. सो एनीवन कॅन टेल, if you are observing this part, who will tell whether it is practical current source or practical voltage source? He kasha sarke dista, practical current source ka practical voltage source? Already we have discussed in the types of sources. This is voltage source, no? Along with internal resistance, like, so this will consider as a practical voltage source. So Thevenin's equivalent circuit is nothing but practical voltage source between two terminals A and B. A and B across load resistor connect kara, so that will give the Thevenin's equivalent circuit. So how to find out VTH? How to find out RTH? VTH is known as Thevenin's voltage VTH, and RTH is known as Thevenin's resistor RTH. Okay, so VTH we can find out by open this two terminals, म्हणजे load resistor remove करायचा आणि find out करायचं VTH between these two terminals. Similarly, we can find out by opening these two terminals, you can find out the RTH by observing from right hand side or left hand side, whatever. So RTH you can find out by this side and measure from opposite side. By finding out RTH, all independent voltage sources we are making it short, all independent current sources we are making it open. That already we have solved the number of examples based on the equivalent resistance. Okay, so this is what the graphical method to understand the Thevenin's theorem. So any questions, any doubts? So next one, how to apply the Thevenin's theorem, or how to select which procedure we have to apply? Okay, whether the problem is based on method 1 type 1, or whether the problem is based on method 2 type 2. So method 1 means type 1. So based on that, we have to follow the procedure. Little bit changes will be there in the steps in the procedure. So method 1 or type 1 means what? When all sources are independent, when only the sources of independent types are present in the given network, means all sources are independent, present in the given network. That problem we have to consider as a type 1. So type 2 or method 2 means what? When sources of both independent as well as dependent types are present. Doni paise, independent as well as dependent. Then that type of circuit is considered under method 2 or type 2. So based on the type 1 and type 2, we have to follow the steps. We have to follow that procedure accordingly. And we have to solve the examples. So we can move towards the next slide. So it is type 1 now. So type 1, in the step 1 is there. Consider the circuit diagram. Consider the circuit diagram by opening the terminals with respect to which? Consider the circuit diagram by opening the terminals with respect to which the Thevenin's equivalent circuit is to be found. म्हणजे दोन टर्मिनल त्यांनी दिलेले आहेत का ते चेक करायचं. वी हॅव टू ऑब्झर्व द सर्किट अँड चेक वेदर टू टर्मिनल्स आर गिवन ऑर नॉट. इफ नॉट गिवन यू हॅव टू आयडेंटिफाय बाय रीडिंग द क्वेश्चन. मीन्स दे विल आस्क द करंट पासिंग थ्रू रजिस्टर, वोल्टेज अक्रॉस रजिस्टर लाईक दिस. सो दॅट रजिस्टर यू हॅव टू कन्सिडर एज अ लोड रजिस्टर अँड दॅट रजिस्टर इज कनेक्टेड बिटवीन टू पॉईंट्स. दोज टू पॉईंट्स यू हॅव टू कन्सिडर एज अ two terminals of the given network. So when we solve the example, you can get the idea. Actually, what is the meaning of this step? You can get the idea when we will solve the first example. So consider the circuit by opening the terminals with respect to which the Thevenin's equivalent circuit is to be found. So after identify the two terminals, you can make it open. The two terminals tumhala open karayacha aahe. Okay, if any resistor is there, you can remove it and make it open. So next step two. So we are talking about method one, when only independent sources are present. So what is the type two, step two, sorry. In step two, find out Thevenin's voltage VTH. Find Thevenin's voltage VTH across open terminals of above circuit. Okay. So when you are opening the two terminals, across that you have to find out the voltage. That voltage is nothing but Thevenin's voltage VTH. So you have to find out VTH in the step number two. So in the step number three, find Thevenin's resistance RTH. TH is for Thevenin's. TH means Thevenin's. Find Thevenin's resistance RTH across the open terminals by eliminating independent sources. Means eliminate kasa karayacha? By shorting the voltage source, by opening the current source. We are doing only with independent sources. So equivalent resistance you have to find out between two terminals. That resistance is nothing but Thevenin's resistance RTH. In the step number four, draw the Thevenin's equivalent circuit by connecting Thevenin's voltage VTH in series with Thevenin's resistance RTH. And then across two terminals, you can connect the load resistor and you can find out the further things based on the question. That will be the extra step, that is step number five. So these are the four steps you have to follow. But these four steps you can understand when we will solve the first example based on the type one. So any questions in the procedure of type one? Kunal ka questions hai? Okay. So now next, type two. Or method two, when sources of both independent and dependent types are present. म्हणजे जेव्हा सर्किट मध्ये तुम्हाला इंडिपेंडेंट बरोबर डिपेंडेंट सोर्स पण दिसतील तेव्हा थेवेनिन्स थेरम कसं अप्लाय करायचं, विच प्रोसिजर, विच स्टेप्स वी हॅव टू अप्लाय. ओके, सो दॅट स्टेप्स, दो स्टेप्स आर गिवन हियर. स्टेप नंबर वन अँड स्टेप नंबर टू आर द सेम. कन्सिडर फर्स्ट, आय एम टॉकिंग अबाउट स्टेप नंबर वन. Consider the circuit diagram by opening the terminals with respect to which the Thevenin's equivalent circuit is to be found. Means if any load resistor is there between two terminals, you can remove it and make it open. That is the first step. Second step, find out the Thevenin's voltage VTH across the open terminals of the circuit. Okay, these two steps will be same, but third step is different here. मग प्रीवियस प्रीवियस मध्ये थर्ड स्टेप काय होता, फाइंड आउट द थेवेनिन्स आरटीएच, थेवेनिन्स रेजिस्टन्स आरटीएच बाय इक्विवेलेंट रेजिस्टन्स मेजर्ड बिटवीन टू टर्मिनल्स. हियर यू कॅन नॉट फाइंड आउट लाइक दिस. एनीवन कॅन टेल व्हॉट इज द रीजन बिहाइंड दिस? आपण इथं आरटीएच फाइंड आउट करू शकत नाही डिपेंडेंट सोर्स जर असेल तर. व्हॉट इज द रीजन? यस, दीप्ती मोरे, कंचन पाटील, ओम गवळी, तन्मय माळी, व्हॉट इज द रीजन वी कॅनॉट फाइंड आउट द आरटीएच डायरेक्टली हियर इन द मेथड टू? सी, डिपेंडंट सोर्स वी कॅनॉट मेक इट शॉर्ट. म्हणजे असं समजा डिपेंडंट सोर्स आहे, suppose this is dependent source plus minus voltage source is there, we cannot make it short. ते त्याला असं शॉर्ट करू शकत नाही. If it is current source like this, so we cannot open it because the internal resistance we don't know what is that. Okay, if it is ideal sources then we can replace it by short circuit and open circuit, but dependent sources we cannot do anything. That's why we cannot find out the equivalent resistance directly. Are you getting my point? So instead of that you can find out the short circuit current ISC by shorting the two terminals of the network. So whatever you are opening the two terminals, you can short that two terminals, and between these two short circuit you can find out the current. That current is named as ISC, SC for short circuit. So when we'll solve the example based on this, you can try to understand, and then after solving the first example based on the type 2, you can able to understand these all steps easily. So VTH we got in the step 2, ISC you can get in the step number 3, then in the step number 4 you can get the RTH. So RTH is equal to VTH divided by ISC. Okay, now you got VTH, RTH. In the step number 5, you have to draw the Thevenin's equivalent circuit by connecting a voltage, Thevenin's voltage VTH, in series with Thevenin's resistance RTH. Okay, and next in the step number 6, you can connect the load resistor, you can find out the voltage across load resistor, current passing through load resistors. So it depends on the question. The only thing, the difference is here the RTH we cannot find out directly. Instead of that, we have to find out short circuit current ISC, and then VTH and ISC you can take the division and you can get the answer of RTH. That is the one extra step will be getting added. So this problem we have to solve. So Thevenin's equivalent circuit. Okay, Thevenin's equivalent circuit. We have to convert this example. We have to solve this example by using Thevenin's theorem, and we have to find out the current flowing through 20 ohm. Okay, so we can solve this example quickly. So here the question is what? Find the current flowing through 20 ohm, means current flowing through this 20 ohm we have to find out. So I will give the name as capital I or IL. Okay, by Thevenin's theorem. So here you can observe the circuit and tell me whether it is type 1 or type 2.
Type 1.
Yes, so it is belongs to type 1 because independent sources are present only. two independent sources are there. Okay, so all sources are independent means type one. So this problem belongs to type one. Next thing, what we have to find out? Can I find out current sangit later? Current passing through 20 ohm resistor. So 20 ohm resistor will act as what? Load resistor RL. So terminal names are given or not here? Yes, it is given A and B. Jar dile nasel tar kay karaycha? If terminal names are not given, what you have to do? How to identify two terminals? जर हे ए अँड बी दिलं नसेल तर काय करायचं? सपोज आय डोंट नो दे नॉट गिवन द एनी नेम एनी टू टर्मिनल्स, हाऊ टू आयडेंटिफाय द टू टर्मिनल्स? असं जर सर्किट असेल सिम्पल, देन हाऊ टू आयडेंटिफाय द नेम ऑफ टू टर्मिनल्स अँड वेअर इट शुड बी? येस, सी इयर असं जर क्वेश्चन असेल, टर्मिनल नेम्स आर नॉट गिवन, सो यू हॅव टू रीड द क्वेश्चन, फाइंड द करंट फ्लोविंग थ्रू 20 ओहम. फाइंड करंट फ्लोविंग थ्रू 20 ओहम. सो 20 ओहम रजिस्टर विल ऍक्ट एज व्हॉट? लोड रजिस्टर. सो लोड रजिस्टर कुठल्या दोन पॉइंट मध्ये कनेक्ट केलेला आहे? सो वन पॉइंट इज हियर, वन पॉइंट इज हियर. So between these two points, the load resistor 20 is connected. So these two points you have to consider as the two terminals. So top to bottom and left to right, this preference you have to give. So here I will take as a and here I will take as a B. And then when you are identify the type, that is type one or type two, and I mentioning the terminal names. If not mentioned, you can mention. If mentioned already, you can take as it is. But you have to open these two terminals. म्हणजे हा जो रजिस्टर आहे ते तुम्हाला ओपन करायचे आहे. सो ए अँड बी टर्मिनल शुड बी ओपन. ओके, सो वी कॅन सॉल्व्ह दिस एक्झाम्पल अँड वी कॅन फाइंड आउट द करंट पासिंग थ्रू दिस 20 ओम. सो फॉर दॅट पर्पज आय विल शेअर द स्क्रीन. जस्ट वेट. ओके, 5 10 10. Okay, so here the question is, find current passing through 20 ohm resistor using Thevenin's theorem. Okay, find current passing through 20 ohm resistor using Thevenin's theorem. So the diagram will be like this. I will draw the diagram. This is 20 volt. This is 5 ohm. This is 10 ohm. This is 10 ohm. This is 4 ampere. And this is 20 ohm resistor. And we have to find out the current passing through these. That is the IL. And terminal names are here A and B. So we have to solve by using Thevenin's theorem. Okay, so this is belongs to type 1, barabar hai, because all sources are independent. Type 1 means what? All sources are independent. So what are the things you have to find out when we are solving the problem based on type 1? You have to find out first of all VTH, then you have to find out RTH, and then you have to find out current passing through 20, that is the IL. Okay, so these three things you have to find out. Now first we can start with finding out Thevenin's voltage VTH. Thevenin's voltage VTH we have to find out. So for that purpose, we have to draw the diagram and we have to make the two terminals open. Okay. So 20 ohm plus minus as it is. So this is 5 ohm as it is. This is 10 ohm as it is. This is 10 ohm as it is. This 4 ampere as it is. And these two terminals, you have to make it open. This is A, this is B. So VTH you have to find out. So VTH is present. VTH is nothing but open circuit voltage between two terminals of the given network. So first step is over. Two terminals you have to identify and you have to remove the load resistor and you have to make the two terminals open. First step is over. Second step, find out the voltage VTH by opening the two terminals of the network and find out the open circuit voltage. Now VTH we have to find out. So by which method we can find out this example? How to find out the VTH? Kasa find out karayacha? Yes.
Nodal analysis.
Yes. So we have to use the nodal analysis. So VTH, A and B terminal manje kay hacha across voltage same asnar hai because it is parallel. Mag itla voltage kay zala? What is this voltage? This voltage is VTH only. Itha plus and itha minus. Okay, because it is exactly parallel. Barabar hai? म्हणजे 4 एम्पियर करंट सोर्सच्या अक्रॉस व्होल्टेज VTH झाला, म्हणजे इथला नोड व्होल्टेज किती झाला? VTH. सो दिस विल बी द अनदर प्रिन्सिपल नोड. सो दिस व्होल्टेज आय विल गिव द नेम एज V1. सो V1 अँड VTH, दीज टू नोड्स आर देअर, यू कॅन यूज द नोडल अनालिसिस. नोडल अनालिसिस ऑर नोड अनालिसिस यू कॅन यूज. So come to the circuit here. Here you can mark as outgoing. This is outgoing. This is outgoing. Here also this is outgoing. This is incoming and this is zero. Why it is zero? Why it is zero? Why this is 0 ampere? Fast. Kaha 0 ampere hai to? Today the students are not giving the answer. Huh? इकडे करंट जाते का राइट हँड साइडला? यस. बिकॉज ओपन सर्किट इज देअर. ओपन सर्किट मधून करंट फ्लो होत असते का कधी? Okay, so 0 ampere is flowing through here, no current. म्हणजे हा जो 4 ampere current source आहे तो पूर्णपणे लेफ्ट हँड साइड ला जातो, बरोबर आहे? तो डिवाइड होत नाही किंवा काही होत नाही, एज इट इज इट विल मूव टुवर्ड्स द लेफ्ट हँड साइड. ओके, सो हियर राइट हँड साइड इज 0 ampere. ओके, सो हियर स्मॉल पार्ट अप्लाय अप्लाय केसीएल apply KCL at node V1. So assumption is what? Assume V1 is greater than 20 and V1 is greater than VTH. That will be the assumption. So this is outgoing, this is outgoing, this is outgoing. All are the outgoing, means all are the positive terms. So V1 minus 20 divided by 5 plus V1 minus 0 divided by 10. Next, V1 minus VTH divided by 10 is equal to what? 0. So LCM is what? LCM kiti yenar idha?
10.
Okay, LCM is 10. LCM is 10. So it is 2. It is 1, it is 1. So 2 into V1 minus 20 plus V1 plus 1 into V1 minus VTH as it is divided by 20, but goes to the right hand side, sorry, divided by 10, but right multiply with 0 in the right hand side becomes 0. 2 V1 plus V1 plus V1, that is 4 V1 minus VTH as it is. 2 into minus 20 means minus 40, goes to the right hand side becomes plus 40. So this is considered as a equation number 1. Now apply KCL at node VTH. Okay, so assumption will be, assume VTH is greater than V1. Ekas assumption enar in the left hand side, VTH is greater than V1. Okay. So one, this is outgoing, this is incoming, and this is zero. So we can take VTH minus V1 divided by 10 minus 4 plus 0 is equal to 0. So this 0 is the current which is present here. Okay, minus 4 because this is incoming and this is outgoing, VTH minus V1 divided by 10. So VTH minus V1 divided by 10, this minus 4 goes to the right hand side becomes plus 4. So VTH minus V1 is equal to 40. So I will write like this, minus V1 plus VTH plus 40 is equal to second equation. So solve equation number 1 and 2. You can get the answer of V1 and VTH, but we are interested in VTH. Solving equation 1 and 2, we get, okay, so V1 value and VTH, you can tell now. V1 kiti aite ani VTH kiti aite sanga.
V1 kiti 26.66 volt.
Okay, so this is the answer of VTH we got. So second step is over now. Okay, second step means we got the answer of Thevenin's voltage VTH. So once again, observe and read within 1 minute, everyone. Pratyek jan pratyek da pahila pasun te vacha Thevenin's voltage VTH, how I have calculated, what we did. Because if you are understanding the first example, you can understand the second, you can understand the third like this. If you are not understanding the first example, then it is difficult to understand the next examples. Okay. I hope everyone understood now. VTH. Okay. Now next one, Thevenin's resistance, RTH. We have to find out. Thevenin's resistance, RTH, we have to find out. So while finding out the equivalent resistance, what we are doing? The two terminals should be open. A and B terminals should be open here. And while finding out equivalent resistance, if any ideal voltage source is there, we are going to make it short. If any ideal current source is there, we are making it open. Okay. And then we are finding out the equivalent resistance. So we are finding out now. Second thing, Thevenin's resistance. Thevenin's resistance, RTH. So while finding out RTH, 20 ohm is shorted here. So 5 ohm as it is. This is 10 ohm as it is. This 10 ohm as it is. Current source is open. Don't take 20 ohm resistor because between A and B terminal we are keeping open. So you have to find out now this RTH or equivalent resistance here. Now tell me RTH, how to find out quick. While finding out RTH, you have to observe from right to left, but you have to measure from left to right. Okay, so we are finding out the RTH here. Thevenin's resistance RTH. The screen is visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So Thevenin's resistance RTH we are finding out. So in between there is an internet issue. That's why I disconnected. So while finding out RTH, we have to short the voltage source. We have to keep the resistors as it is, 5 ohm. This is 10 ohm. This is 10 ohm. Current source, we have to make it open. And two terminals, we have to keep as it is open. Don't connect 20 ohm here. And we are going to find out by observing between A and B, we are finding out the equivalent resistance RTH, but you can measure from opposite side. So RTH, how to find out now? How the resistors are connected here? 5 and 10 connected, series or parallel?
Series.
How you can say the series? Ikkana bagana? 5 and 10, 5 is suppose here. इथं टर्म इथं करंट डिवाइड होतो की नाही सपोज मी इथून एक करंट पाठवायला लागलो दिस करंट इज सपोज आय वेदर इट विल फ्लोइंग सेम ऑर इट विल फ्लोइंग ऑर इट विल डिवाइड काही करंट 5 ओम मधून जाणार काही करंट 10 ओम मधून जाणार दोन्ही मधला करंट वेगवेगळा असणार इफ करंट विल बी द डिफरंट देन रेजिस्टर्स आर कनेक्टेड इन सीरीज ऑर पॅरलल
Parallel.
Okay, so 5 and 10 are in parallel. Don't confuse. That's why I told, focus on how to find out the equivalent resistance. That is very important point. So 5 and 10 are connected in parallel. And that parallel combination is connected in series with 10. So that's why here plus will come, plus 10. So 5 parallel 10, 5 into 10. Divided by 5 plus 10, this plus 10 as it is. So this 50 divided by 15, that will give 3.33. You can cross check plus 10 as it is. So it will give RTH as 13.33 ohm. So this is step 3. We got now RTH. Now in the step 4, we have to draw the Thevenin's equivalent circuit. Thevenin's equivalent circuit. Okay. So that will consisting of VTH in series with RTH between two terminals A and B. This is called Thevenin's equivalent circuit. So VTH is what? VTH is 66.66 volt. You can mention RTH is 13.33 ohm. So this is what Thevenin's equivalent circuit. Now last point, that is the 4 steps, we have to find out IL, that is the current passing through 20. So for that purpose, I have to draw the Thevenin's equivalent circuit once again. VTH in series with RTH and between A and B terminal, you have to connect the load resistor. RL is equal to 20 ohm. 20 ohm resistor you can connect as it is, and you have to find out this current IL. So how to find out IL? By which method you can find out? Series circuit ahe. इथं रे आरटीएचचं व्हॅल्यू किती आहे 13.33 व्हीटीएच किती आहे 66.66 व्होल्ट सो व्होल्टेज इज नोन रेजिस्टन्स 13.33 अँड 20 बोथ आर इन सिरीज सो व्हॉट विल बी द आयएल बाय ओम्स लॉ यू कॅन फाइंड आउट बाय ओम्स लॉ आयएल इज इक्वल टू टोटल व्होल्टेज व्हीटीएच डिवाइडेड बाय आरटीएच प्लस आरएल So VTH is 66.66 divided by 13.33 plus 20. So 66.66 divided by 33.33. So IL will be, current passing through 20 ohm resistor will be 2 ampere. Now understood the how to solve the examples based on the Thevenin's. So first example we have completed. Kona kai questions asil tar vicharu shakta. Yes. Any doubt, any questions? Okay, so we can take the second example now. Question number 2. Find current. Find current passing through. Find current passing through. Ten ohm resistor using Thevenin's theorem. Find current passing through 10 ohm resistor using Thevenin's theorem. Okay, so I will draw the diagram. You have to identify whether this problem belongs to type 1 or type 2. This is 10 ampere. This is 5 ohm. This is 10 ohm. This is 20 ohm. This is 30 ohm. This is 100 volt. And terminal names are given here. Because terminal names are not given. Okay, you have to identify. So current passing through 10 ohm, you have to find out. So this current you have to find out. So what is the first step? How to start this example to solve? Yes. Think and tell me type, what is the type of circuit and how to identify the two terminals of the given network. Yes. How to identify the type of circuit? Yes. Anyone?
Type one.
Yes, it is type one because only independent sources are there. So we have to use the Thevenin's theorem and we have to solve that given example by using procedure or steps of type 1. Okay, this is very important to identify. Now next one, after that, where are the two terminals? So I will write that this is the Thevenin's theorem we have to use here. Okay, we have to use the Thevenin's theorem. And this is the type 1. So type 1 means, first of all, we have to calculate the VTH. Second thing, we have to calculate the RTH. And then third thing, we have to calculate the current passing through 10 ohm, that is IL. Okay. So where are the two terminals? And how to identify these two terminals? Where are the two terminals? Quick response tumse yet nahi ya? You people are not giving the response. Only a few students are giving response. What other people, other students are now? Try to understand and make the session interactive. Rushali Guru. Yes, present. Rushali Guru. Vaibhavi Kulkarni, roll number 13. Vaibhavi. Whoever I will call, if you are not giving response, you can mark, I will mark you as absent. Aditya Gavate. गावते और गावते रोल नंबर 46 वर्षाली इंगले यस No one is responding means what? Hello? Can we stop now? Because no one is responding. Yes? Hello? Am I audible? आवाज एक बजे का?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Why you people
not? Yes sir.
It is for you people only. I called 4 to 5 names. No one is responding. How I can understand that you people understood or not? Shreyas Kamble, roll number 51. Yes or no? Shreyas, are you present? Okay, I will call according to roll number. Bhaji Bakre?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Shraddha Birazdar?
Yes, sir.
Shubhakti. Shubhakti Deshpande. Sharyu Garad.
Yes, sir.
Urushali. Urushali Gurav. Don't put in a chat box. Kajal Ingle?
Yes, sir.
What I have asked the question, Kajal?
Find out terminals A and B.
Then how to find out? What I told in the previous example, if terminal names are not given, then how to identify? If you are giving the answers, then we can solve number of examples. See, if terminal, not, once again, everyone observe and carefully attend the lectures. Don't be only login and keeping a mobile aside. At the mobile, madhe login hun thevayche nahi bas. You have to attend the lectures very sincerely. Because such type of difficult subject, you have to solve the number of examples because in the exam, they will ask the numerical questions only. So physically exam zale tar khup avgad asnar hai tumcha. So find out the current passing through 10 ohm resistor using Thevenin's theorem. In that 10 ohm resistor will act as what? Load resistor, okay? So 10 ohm resistor kutla don terminal madhe connect zale. So this is the first terminal and this is the second terminal. So this terminal I will take as a and this terminal I will take as a b. Always give from left to right or top to bottom. म्हणजे नाव ए कुठे द्यायचं, लेफ्ट साइडला किंवा टॉप टू बॉटम मध्ये टॉपला. सो ए टू बी आय हॅव मार्क. ओके, सो नाव आय हॅव टू मेक ओपन ए अँड बी टर्मिनल्स. ओके, अँड देन वी कॅन फाइंड आउट द व्ही टी एच. सो फॉर दॅट पर्पज आय विल ड्रॉ द डायग्राम. सो दिस विल बी द 10 ampere current source. So this will be the 5 ohm. So these two terminals I will make it open. So this is 20 ohm as it is. This is 30 ohm as it is. This plus minus 100 volt as it is. So this will be the terminal B and this will be terminal A. So where should be VTH? VTH is nothing but the open circuit voltage between two terminal A and B. So VTH we have to find out here between terminal A and B. So anyone can tell how to find out VTH now? Yes, how to find out VTH? Anyone, can you think how to find out VTH? See here, VTH manje kay? VTH means voltage at a point or potential at a point minus potential at b point, or voltage difference between two point is nothing but voltage. Okay, so VTH is equal to VA minus VB. So VA means this voltage, this considered as a VA and this considered as a VB. So VA means what? Voltage across 5 ohm plus minus, and VB means what? Voltage across 20 ohm. So VA you can find out, that is voltage across 5 ohm. VB you can find out, that is voltage across 20 ohm. So I will write where VA is equal to voltage across 5 ohm resistor, and VB is nothing but voltage across 20 ohm resistor. Now understood now how to find out VTH. VTH means what? VA means potential at A point and VB means potential at B point. So VA minus VB finding out, then you can get the VTH. So for that purpose, you have to find out first of all VA, that is voltage across 5 ohm. Then you can find out VB, that is voltage across 20. And then you can make the subtraction, you can get the answer of VTH. Now question is how to find out VA and VB. So this is the loop one, this is loop one, this is loop two. So in the loop one, you can get the answer of VA, and in the loop two, you can get the answer of VB. So who will tell what is the answer of VA? So current 10 ampere current is there. So 10 ampere current source is flowing through 5 ohm. बरोबर आहे. हा करंट किती असणार आहे? 10 एम्पियर. सो 10 एम्पियर करंट इज फ्लोइंग थ्रू 5 ओम. सो 5 इंटू 10 करा, यू कॅन गेट द व्ही ए. सो व्ही ए इज इक्वल टू 5 इंटू 10 एम्पियर करंट. सो दॅट विल गिव 50 वोल्ट. व्ही ए इज इक्वल टू 50 वोल्ट फ्रॉम दिस, यू कॅन गेट फ्रॉम लूप वन. Now next, from loop two, so in the loop two, what you have to do? you can apply the voltage division. Current 100 volt hai, 100 volt is there, and two resistors are in series now, 30 and 20. So VB is nothing but voltage across 20. So that you can get by current, by voltage division. So by voltage division, because loop 2 is the series circuit. In series circuit, two resistors are there in series, and 100 ohm, 100 volt is also connected in series. So voltage across 20 you can get by using voltage division. So voltage division you can use and find out the voltage across 20, that is VB. By voltage division, VB is equal to total voltage 100 into 20 ohm divided by 20 plus 30. So 100 into 20 divided by 50. So it will give VB is equal to 40 volt. Okay, VA is equal to 50 and VB is 10. Therefore, you can get now VTH value. Now, VTH is equal to VA minus VB. VA is 50 minus VB is 40. So, VTH answer is 10 volt. So VTH you can get by taking VA minus VB. VA is nothing but voltage across 5 ohm. So voltage across 5 ohm, you can find out if you know the current passing through that. So already know that the current passing through 5 ohm will be 10 ampere. So 10 into 5 kara, tumhala 50 milen. So here also the series circuit is there. By using voltage division, you can find out the voltage across 20. So voltage across 20 is nothing but VB. So take the subtraction and you can get the answer of VTH. So any questions in the finding out VTH? Yes or no? Once again.
No, sir. No, sir.
Okay. So next, RTH you have to find out. Thevenin's resistance. Thevenin's resistance. RTH. So while finding out RTH, what we have to do? Kay karavacha hai tha? 10 ampere current source, short or open?
Open.
Yes, it is open. Next, 5 ohm, keep as it is, 5 ohm. And this is terminal A. Now this terminal should be open. Next, I will take here. So 20 ohm, keep as it is, 20 ohm. So this is terminal B as it is. Here 30 ohm, keep as it is. And what about 100 ohm, 100 volt voltage source? Kaya asana re? Short ka open?
Short.
Yes, so it is short. Okay, now you have to observe, you have to measure the voltage at between, sorry, the resistance between A and B terminal. So how to find out the answer of this RTH now by observing between A and B? How the resistors are connected? Yes, how to find out how the resistors are connected. So I will convert this circuit into simple circuit so that you can easily find out. Okay, so what I will do, I will convert into a single simple circuit. So, so this is suppose A terminal is there. So A terminal means 5 ohm will be there. Okay, next. So this is B terminal is here, means here 20. Okay, you can consider as a B terminal. So from here 30 will be there. So if you are considering this as a C point, so A, and here also you can consider as a C point. So between A and C, 5 ohm is there. Between B and C, 20 is there. Between B and C, 30 is also there. And B point you can take. Now you can observe from left to right and find out RTH. Now tell me how the resistors are connected. Measure from opposite side. Thoda mi modification kele circuit madhe, so that you can find out the answer of RTH. Yes, RTH is equal to how the 30 and 20 are connected?
Parallel.
Yes. So 20 is connected in parallel with 30. That is in series with 5.
5.
Okay. So 20 and 30. 20 into 30 divided by 20 plus 30. So divided by is equal to 5 as it is. So 600 divided by 50, that will give 12. Next, plus 5 as it is. So RTH answer will be 17 ohm. Okay. So 17 ohm will be the answer of RTH. Now next question, find out the current passing through this 10 ohm. Okay. So between A and B terminal, you have to connect the 10 ohm as it is, and Thevenin's equivalent circuit you have to draw. So second step, VTH we calculated, third step RTH we have calculated. Now we have to draw the Thevenin's equivalent circuit. We have to connect the 10 ohm resistor between A and B terminal, and we have to find out the current IL. So Thevenin's, so I will combinedly write here Thevenin's equivalent circuit and IL. So Thevenin's equivalent circuit consisting of voltage source VTH in series with RTH. So this is terminal A, this is terminal B, and between A and B terminal, whatever you remove the 10 ohm, that you can connect as it is. Now you have to find out this current as a IL. Okay, so VTH we calculated, VTH we got, VTH kiti ala hota? 10 volt. RTH we got 17 ohm. This is already 10 ohm. So by using simple Ohm's law, you can get the IL. By using simple Ohm's law, you can get the IL. So IL is equal to VTH divided by RTH plus RL. VTH is 10 divided by 17 plus 10. So IL is equal to 10 divided by 27. That is 0.37 ampere. Okay, so this is called as what? Thevenin's equivalent circuit between terminal A and B. So now understood the second example? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So one more example we can solve, and then we can stop. One more example we can solve. That will be the very simple one. Within 10 to 15 minutes, we can complete it. Question number 3. Determine current passing through. Determine. Sorry. We can like this. Voltage across determine voltage across 10 ohm resistor using Thevenin's theorem. Okay, so I will draw the diagram. You have to identify the type of circuit and then we can start. So there will be, we have to increase the speed now because already we have solved two examples. Okay, so this is the circuit diagram. Now tell me what will be the type of circuit and how to start.
Type 1.
Yes, so we have to use the Thevenin's theorem. Okay, so it is type 1. So in type 1 we are finding out VTH, second thing RTH, and third thing VL, that is voltage across 10 ohm. VL kiwa V10 manu shakta. Okay, so where will be the terminals? Terminals kuthe? Where are the terminals? Where is 10 ohm? Determine voltage across 10 ohm means 10 ohm resistor acts as what? Load resistor. Mag tu kutla don point madhe connect zale? Here. Okay, so this I will consider as A, this I will consider as a B. So I will make the open two terminals open A and B by rooming by opening this 10 ohm resistor. Now I will start to find out the first of all VTH. So 10 ohm resistor remove by opening terminals A and B. Okay, so here we are going to calculate the first thing, that is the VTH. So for that purpose, this is 10 ampere as it is. This is 12 ohm as it is. This is 5 ampere. This is 4 ohm. This is 3 ampere.
Current kiti hai sir? 12 ampere ka 10 ampere hai.
Yes. So here it is. This will be 12 ampere, 12 ohm, 5 ampere, 4 ohm, 3 ampere, and we are making A and B terminals open. So between A and B terminal, we are finding out VTH. Okay. Now how to find out this VTH? By which method we can find out the VTH? If you are observing this one, the voltage across 3 ampere will be the VTH. Current to exact parallel. त्याला एक्झॅक्ट पॅरलल हा 4 ओम रेजिस्टर आहे त्यामुळे त्याच्या अक्रॉस पण व्होल्टेज सेमच असणार कारण इथं कुठलंच कंपोनंट नाही आहे सो दिस व्होल्टेज इज VTH व्हॉट इज दिस व्होल्टेज दॅट व्होल्टेज वी डोंट नो सो आय विल कीप ॲज अ V1 ओके सो ॲट दिस पॉइंट हाऊ मेनी ब्रांचेस आर देअर दिस इज द फर्स्ट ब्रांच 12 एम्पियर करंट सोर्स यू कॅन टेक इनकमिंग ॲज इट इज दिस इज आउटगोइंग and this is already outgoing, that is the 5 ampere. So you can apply the KCL here, nodal analysis. Next VTH, here this is the incoming 5 ampere. This is outgoing and this 3 ampere cannot go to the right hand side because right hand side is zero. Open circuit is zero. So 3 ampere will come to here. So you can apply KCL at only this VTH. There is no need to apply the KCL at V1. So instead of applying the KCL at V1, if you are applying directly VTH at VTH, you can get the answer of VTH. Apply KCL at VTH. So minus 5, next plus VTH minus 0 divided by 4. म्हणजे या ब्रांच साठी VTH minus 0 because here ground will be there. Okay. So next minus 3. Two incoming currents are there, minus 5 and minus 3 असल्यामुळे. And VTH divided by 4 is equal to 0. So here VTH divided by 4 minus 8 is equal to 0. So VTH divided by 4 is equal to 8. Minus 8 goes to the right hand side, becomes plus 8. So VTH is equal to 4 into 8 is 32 volt. So within one step, you can get the answer. Okay. Now, observe everyone and read how we solve this example. Now, second one, we have to find out RTH, Thevenin's resistance, RTH, we have to find out between terminal A and B. But while finding out RTH, all current sources should be open. Okay, because there is only current sources are available. So 12 ampere current source open. So only 12 ohm will come here. 5 ampere current source, that is also open. So only 4 ohm resistor will come. 3 ampere current source already open. And A and B terminal should be open. So this is A, this is B. And we have to observe between A and B. So what will be the value of RTH? Who will tell what will be the value of RTH now? You have to observe between A and B only. So this is floating. 12 ohm resistor cha ek point connect jala itha, but second point is not connected, it is disconnected. So what will be the value of RTH? Yes, between A and B terminal, what will be the resistance value? Whether it is 12 plus 4, whether it is 12 parallel 4, whether it is only 4.
Only 4.
Only?
4.
Yes, very good. So 12 will not come. Current 12's second point kutas connect zalil nahi. It is disconnected. Therefore, only if you are observing between A and B, only 4 ohm will be there. Manje jar tumhi the current source connect kela tar fakt current ya loop madhe spiral ikade janaras nahi to, because it is open. So only 4 ohm will be the answer. So this is what RTH. Now third thing, Thevenin's equivalent circuit. And VL we have to find out. Thevenin's equivalent circuit, we have to draw plus minus. This is VTH, this is RTH, this is A terminal, this is B terminal. This resistor is 10 ohm. So we have to find out the voltage across 10 ohm. Okay, so RTH is 4 ohm, VTH is 32 volt, and you have to find out the voltage across 10 ohm, that is VL. So how to find out VL? By which method you can find out? Series circuit is there, total voltage is there, two resistors are connected in series. So which concept you can use?
voltage division.
So by voltage division you can find out. By voltage division. So VL is equal to total voltage VTH into RL divided by RL plus RTH. Okay, so VTH is 32 into RL is 10, so divided by 10 plus 4. So anyone calculate and tell me what is the VL answer?
Twenty-two point eighty-five volt.
So this will be the answer. When the current which are letter Ohm's law. And voltage which are letter voltage division that will be applied at the last stage. Okay. So this problem asked in the university question paper. But it is asked in maximum power transfer theorem. But in the maximum power transfer theorem also, we have to use the Thevenin's theorem. So one more example we can solve in the next lecture, and then we can solve the type 2 problem, and after that we can move towards the Norton's theorem. So anyone having any questions, any doubts? Okay, we can stop now.